My dear children, welcome to the Business Studies class. Today in this fourth module, we are going to study some important international trade institutions. The first one is World Bank. The International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, IRDI, commonly known as World Bank. This World Bank was a result of the Bretton Woods Conference. The main objectives for setting up this international organization were to aid the task of reconstruction of the war-affected economies of Europe and assist in the development of the underdeveloped nations of the world. For the first few years, the World Bank remained preoccupied with the task restoring war nations in Europe. Having achieved success in accomplishing this task by late 1950s, the World Bank turned its attention to the development of underdeveloped nations. It realized that by investing more and more in these countries, especially in social sectors like health and education, it could bring about the needed social and economic transformation of the developing countries. To give shape to this investment aspect in these underdeveloped nations, the International Development Association, that is IDA, was formed in the year 1960. The main objectives of IDA has been to provide loans on concessional terms and conditions to those countries whose per capita income are below a critical level. Concessional terms and conditions means that repayment period is much longer than the repayment period of IBRD. The borrowing nation need to pay any interest on the borrowed amount. IDA thus provides interest-free long-term loans to the poor nations. Long-term loans are the loans which are provided and repaid after 1 year. IBRD also provides loans, but these carry interest charged on commercial basis. Over this time, the additional organizations have been set up under the umbrella of the World Bank. Today, the World Bank is a group of international organizations responsible for providing finance to the different countries. The group and the affiliated headquarters in Washington, D.C. catering to various financial needs are listed in the box, the World Bank and its affiliates. Next, we are going to study the important functions of the World Bank. As we know, the important functions of the commercial banks are receiving deposits, lending money, discounting various bill of exchange, then locker facilities, then providing various loans and advances to the customers. These are the important functions of commercial banks. In the same way, the next module we are going to study the important functions of the World Bank.